Today, I'm going to teach you how to make a saving leader stat system, so when you leave the game and join back in, all your progress will be saved. As you can see, I've joined back in, and all my stuff have been saved. And if you want to see how to make this item collection system, you can watch this video in the top right. Alright, to start off, click on your server script service and insert a new script. Alright, you can ignore these other two scripts since these are from a previous video. So, let's get started by creating a data store. So let's go local data store service is going to be equal to game colon get service, and we're going to be getting data store service. Now in here, it doesn't matter if you use quotation marks or if you use apostrophes. I like using apostrophes. I'm going to set that to be a capital S. Let's drop a line. Let's go local player data is going to be equal to data store service colon, where we have to get a data store, and the data store that we're going to be getting is my data store. Now in here you can actually write whatever you want, although I'm writing my data store just because it's easy. Now if you were to change this at any time when your game is published, it's going to save to a new data store. So in here we can type only change if, no wait, if data store name is changed, then player progress, I can't spell progress, will be wiped. I actually can't spell progress. Whatever, I don't care if I spelled that right. Anyway, so if this data source changes, every player's progress will be wiped, right? So let's drop like two lines, or actually I'll drop one line. And now let's create a local function. It's gonna be equal to on player join. So this is gonna happen when the, actually let's just call this player join. So when the player joins, we're going to get our player. All right. And outside of here, we have to get our leader stats. So in here, you're going to need a leader stat system already. For example, I have this leader stats, as you can see. You should see it something like this. Now we have to get our leader stats. So the way we do that is let's go local leader stats is equal to player colon wait for child, and then we have to wait for leader stats. Actually, we haven't renamed the script yet. Let's rename this to data save. Inside of resources, as you can see, this is our leader stats. You might have your leader stats name as something different. Whoops, I closed that. Alright, so make sure that if you have multiple, you can only have one data store per server. So if you have like two data stores, you're going to have a few errors. You can only have one data store per game, not server. Or I think it's actually like per place. Anyways, now let's go get our items that are inside our leader stats. So inside our leader stats, we have our wood. So let's go, local wood. This, what you want to call this, is the exact same name as what you have here. So if this is money, then you're then just rename your data store over here to money, just to make it easier. Once this mine's wood, I'm going to call it wood. Now, if you want to get this exact data store and get that and get this item collection system, then remember, go watch the video. It'll be in the description. Okay, so let's go local wood is equal to leader stats colon wait for child, and then we are going to be waiting for our wood. Well, actually wood. Now this, the name of this doesn't matter, you're just going to want to remember this, but over here this has to be specific. So inside your resources script, this has to be exactly the same name. If like, so for example, if this is a lowercase and this is a capital, it won't work. That's pretty much case sensitive. So whatever money or item you're getting from your leader stat script, you're going to want to make sure it's the exact same over here. All right, so over here, let's go local stone. Like I said, the variable name doesn't matter. So local stone is going to be equal to leader stats colon wait for child. And then what are we going to be waiting for? Stone. Whoops. Stone. This is, I can't spell stone. Like I said, this has to be the exact same. Now, if you have more resources, let's say you have, I'm just going to copy this. Let's say they have another resource like, I don't know, iron, or let's just go money. If you have money, then you're just going to want to make another one like this and go over here. You're going to want to change this money, and over here, remember, case sensitive, money. All right, I only have two, so I can delete that one. All right, so now let's go. Now we're going to be getting our player user ID. So local player user ID is going to be equal to our player. Oops, it's going to be player underscore dot dot and then player dot user ID. And now let's go local. Whoops, data is going to be equal to player user ID. Whoops, player user ID. Or no, not player user ID, but player data. Sorry about that. So remember, this is our player data. So player data colon get async, just like that. And now we want to get our player user ID. So what we're doing is we're just getting the data store here, and we're going to get the items that are saved inside the data store. So then we're going to go if data. So if anything is saved inside the data store, then would dot value. Remember, would is the same name as this is. So would is going to be equal to this right here. So what is your would? So would dot value is equal to data, and then we are going to replace that data with would. So would dot value is going to be equal to our saved data. Okay, let me explain this simply. So would dot value is going to be equal to our wood data, which is saved right here. So whatever amount that the data source saved when we exit the game, it's going to overwrite our current value with the value that we had previously. Anyways, now we have stone.value. Value is going to be equal to data and stone. Like I said, it's going to work exactly the same as the previous one. But let's say that, but now if you don't have any, pretty much if it's your first time playing, we're going to have to give the player a value. So if this is the player's first time playing, or if they just don't have anything saved in their data store, we'll go would.value equals 0. Now, this is player starting amount. All right. So however you want the player, whatever amount of wood you, let's say you want the player to start off, then that's going to be your value. So let's say I want the player to start off with 50 wood, then just set that to 50. But I don't want the player to have any wood. And now we also have our stone.value. So we're going to go stone.value is going to be equal to 0, because I don't want the player to have any amount when they start off. Now, like I said, if you had money over here, so if you had an extra value, then you're just going to want to get that exact variable. So let's say your variable over here was, I'll copy and paste this again. Like I said, if you had an extra one called money, and then this is money. Over here, you're just going to want to add money dot value is going to equal to data, and then the data is going to be money, right? And then over here, I'm pretty sure you get the idea. You just have to do money. Now, these variables have to be what this variable is, although this has to be what your actual name of the currency is. So this is your variable right here, and then this is the name of the currency. But I don't have money in my data store, so I can remove that. Perfect. We're pretty much done with managing our money. And now we can start a new script. Let's create local function. Let's go create. Create table. And our player. Alright. So local player stats. It's gonna be equal to a table. Now a table are two of these curly brackets. Alright. So for underscore comma stat in pairs player dot leader stats colon get children. There you go. And then we can just go outside of this do. So for every child inside of leader stats, it's gonna create a stat name and a stat value. So what a child is inside of here, as you can see, we are parenting our wood resource or our wood currency to the leader stats. So if I were to go into our workspace and create a part, all right, and now if I were to add a script inside of this part, this script would be the child of this part, and the part would be the parent of the script. So if you have multiple scripts, then you have multiple childs, right? So this part is multiple childs, but each child only has one parent. So what this script's going to do, what this is going to do is it's going to go through every child and create a stat value for it. All right? I think that's how it works. Hopefully I just didn't give the wrong explanation. But that's how getChild works. It's just going to go and get every child. Anyways, let's go player stats. And then we're going to create some square brackets. Stat.name. And the name of the stat is going to be stat.value. All right. So for the stat name, we're going to give its value. Anyways, now we can just go return. And we're just going to return our player stats. There we go. On to our last function. So local function. On local function, and let's go player exited. Or actually, let's just call this player exit. And then let's go player. Right? So let's go local player stats equals, we're going to create a table and player. I can't spell player. I'm going to create a table in the player, then local success equals, let's just go error, which is kind of going to be short for error, since if we just go error, it's going to create a little thing like that, and we don't want that. So local error, success, comma, error is going to be equal to pcall and function local player user ID, right? It's going to be equal to player underscore dot dot player dot user ID. All right, let's drop line. Player data colon set async player user ID and player stats. There we go. And now we don't really need this, but if not success, then well, we can, we don't really need this, but let's just warn the player that the data save failed or could not save data. There we go. So we're just creating a little warning. And over here, let's just create game dot players dot player added colon connect function. No, colon connect on. Let's go player join. Let's remove that. And let's go game dot players dot player removing colon connect, and then player exit. Let's remove those two things. And just like that, we have our data save. Although it's not finished yet, because let's say that see, when the player leaves, the server closes immediately, right? But the server only closes if you're the last player. And that's a little issue, since if this script doesn't have time to run and save the last player's data, the player's data just won't save. So in order to actually have that player's data saved, we can create a new script in here. And let's rename this script to, let's rename the script to exit wait. There we go. Now, what we can do is pretty much game colon bind to close function. Inside of here, we can just go wait 3, just like that. Although what I'm going to do is print, or actually let's go warn game close game ready to close, and just like that. And we can go warn game close. Now, depending how many resources you, or how many how many items you have in your leader stats, or money, or currencies, you might want to tinker around with this value and get a good value for the player's leader stats to save. But anyways, inside of resources, you can rename this. So I'm just going to call this showcase. All right, just so I can show you that this perfectly works. So if we go hit play, as you can see, we have our stone, wood, and money. Let's go collect. Let's get all these resources. Let's stop the game. As you can see, it's going to wait 3 seconds, so you're going to be on a little freeze screen like that. It got its warn. Game close. Oh, sorry. We got a little error. Get children. All right, there we go. I spelled children wrong there. We got a little error, and it just didn't save. So now that I fixed that error, this should work perfectly fine. We close, it's going to wait 3 seconds before the server fully closes. And as you can see, game ready to close, game closed. And now if we hit play again, you should see that our data is saved. Perfect. Anyways, if you want to create this item collection system, the video will be on screen right now. And thank you for watching. Make sure to subscribe. And if you have any further questions, join the Discord. So thanks for watching. Bye.